My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and today we're taking a look at lower thirds in Apple Motion. You may notice that my motion is probably a little different than what you've seen in the past. This is the new update as of November 2016. So if yours doesn't look like this, just go ahead and go to the App Store and make sure that you update your motion to follow along properly. I got a message earlier today from a Travis Watson asking, how do you make Q&A style graphics that he sees in a lot of these different YouTube videos or Twitter or Instagram? So let's go ahead and take a look at that. This is my motion document. Let's take a look and see how this is built. So I just have two main groups right here. Is I have my lower third bar, and by the way, it's called a lower third because it sits at the lower third of your screen. And then underneath that is I actually have a white solid just for me to kind of check my background. A lot of times I'll use this just to check my drop shadows and make sure that they're really nice and clean. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and turn that off. And I'm going to open up my other group right now, and we're just going to take a look at this and then build it out. So I have one main bar. I'm going to solo this by hitting my Alt Option key. And in this bar, you'll notice I just have a solid bar with a gradient. I like having a gradient on here for this little bit of white, so that way when I stack my layers, you get this little bit of highlight. If I don't have that on here, it looks a little flat. That's really up to you, but I just like to have that in there to give a little bit of contrast. On top of that, I've got a little bit of a highlight, and right in here, you can see that it's kind of created this little bit of a scoop. And then on top of that, I have something here called a blink. And my blink is this thing that moves across here. So when I play all this back, you can see my text pops up and I've got that little blink going across there. We have our title and our subtitle, and those have a little bit of animation in there. And then I have my logo. So right here is I have a drop zone, and in that drop zone, I actually have a YouTube icon. And what's great about using these drop zones is I can actually go ahead and put in a different icon. So let's say I've got Twitter here. So I'm going to go ahead and drop this Twitter in here. And you'll notice it's a little large right now, and that's okay because we're just going to go into our drop zone and scale that down. Now, obviously, that doesn't work, so we can go into our main and I can just change these colors to a bit of a blue. All right, so now that we've seen this, let's go ahead and start constructing this because there's just a couple things that I didn't talk about here that's gonna make a little bit more sense once we dig into this. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new project and let's start from scratch. So here's my project. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm just going to zoom out so I can kind of see where everything is. The second thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come up to my view, which is up here in this top right corner, and I'm actually gonna turn on something here called Save Zones. So I actually do a lot of graphics for television broadcast, and these safe zones are really what you can get away with broadcasting. Anything that has words in it has to be within this line. Anything that has action has to be within this line. There's lots of specific reasons why we use those. I'm not going to talk about them right now. Anytime you're going to have graphics on a television for broadcast, you absolutely need to make use of these. For me, I'm just gonna make use of these so I know where my lower thirds are best going to sit. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep that on for right now, and I'm using it almost like a ruler. I'm gonna go down to my rectangle tool here, and I'm just gonna draw out a rectangle, and we'll make it about yay big there. And I'm gonna call this group that I made right here, lower third. And I'm gonna call this one subtitle. Let's go ahead and give this a color and change it from a color to a gradient. And hey, that's a pretty good gradient if I was looking for Twitter. But we're going to make ours for YouTube. So I'm just going to go ahead and pick something a little red here. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to duplicate this subtitle bar by hitting Command D while it's selected. And I'm going to call this one Title. Now, what's great about this is it is the exact same size and shape and color and everything of that top bar. So all I have to do now is just kind of drag this up to right about here. I'm going to zoom this in so we can see that a little bit better. And I'm going to change this now from a gradient to a color solid. And we're going to go ahead and make this pretty dark. By the way, what I tend to do a lot is I turn off my color and put on my transparency. So now, there we go. We can see that we have our rectangles, and there is our subtitle and our title bar. Now that we have that, I'm actually going to duplicate that guy again. And what I'm going to do with this is we're going to make this a bit grayer. Now that I have this secondary shape, I'm actually going to go into my geometry of it. I'm going to convert it to points right away. And the reason why I'm converting it to points is I want this point. I'm going to right-click this point and make it a smooth point. And I'm going to do the same for this other side. I'm going to right-click it and hit smooth. And now I'm going to drag these handles. All right, that's looking pretty good so far. It's a little bright for me, so I'm actually going to just cheat a little bit and turn down its opacity here. Okay, so far so good. So the next thing I want to do is I'm going to create one more rectangle, and we're going to give it a color that's the same as this guy here. So far so good. We've got our title bar and our subtitle bar and our reveal bar. And now I'm just going to go ahead and put some text together. So we're just going to write our text right about here. And you want to make sure you give enough room for people with really long names, like stupid made-up names like Stanislaw Robert Liberta. I mean, that's a lot of name here. So we got to make sure that fits. And we're just going to work with that text here. Little bit, and we're going to call this title text. And just like before, I'm going to duplicate it, and we're going to move him down here. Make sure that I'm going in a straight line down using my Y coordinates. And whenever we have our subtitles here, we want to make sure that we make them a little smaller, because right now they're both the same size, and that looks kind of ridiculous. And in fact, I can just write. And so this is at 57. Let's take this down to, let's say, 50. We have plenty of room for our text, and that's starting to look pretty good. This reveal bar is probably a little long, and I didn't name him. Let me rename him. And I'm going to get in here and just scoot him down. I'm going to go into his properties and add a drop shadow. The next thing I want to do is actually add in my drop zone. So I'm going to go up to my object and new drop zone. And it is a huge drop zone. And we're going to call this drop zone logo. I'm going to just resize this. And we're going to put it right about here. I can't imagine anything else that's really going to be coming off this way. In fact, though, let's go ahead and select everything. Just move it on over, just so we have a little bit more room. Because it's going to be for the web, I don't really care too much about title safe. I'm going to go to my desktop and just drag in this YouTube logo and drop that right in there. Now it's a little large. You can see that it is not fitting in correctly, and that's okay. I'm going to go to my image in my drop zone tab and just start scaling this down until it fits, right? So right about there makes it pretty square. I think it's right around 55. And I can go ahead and bring that just a bit closer here. Now, again, the reason why I like drop zones so much is really I can put anything I want into this. If I go ahead and play this back, it's going to play right here, but disappears here. So just be aware of where your layers are. So I can select all of them, hit the letter I, they all start there. So now let's start part two, which is actually animating these pieces.